to hear us all over the world. I'm Safitri from Education One Australia. Yeah, I know, it's been a long, long, long day since Education One's last post on this YouTube channel. Thank you for staying with us in these hard times. Keep your chin up, mates, because today we're not going to talk about nonsense dramas and complaining. It's time for us to raise up and back to reality. We are here to show you some legit paths to pursue your dream, or at least show you the other interesting options that you have. But before that, are you assumed to be the diploma graduate from universities in Australia and your visa is expiring soon? Or are you just a well-prepared student who plans everything to the tiniest thing of your future? Well, 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 we have better ideas for you. Instead of leaving Australia shortly after graduating to your home country, why don't you stay a bit longer in Australia and get a ball rolling on your skill improvements? Have you ever heard about TRA? Trades Recognition Australia. If your major of study is included in the trade category with a minimum qualification of a certificate 3, you can apply for a different visa subclass to prolong your stay in Australia. These majors are examples of trade courses: commercial cookery, patisserie, bricklaying, and many other courses. And the most suitable visa for you will be temporary graduate visa, subclass 485, or working visa, or skilled visa in Australia. These visas require assessment by relevant authority. Okay, here is the brief introduction about them. First, working visa or skilled visa in Australia. And yes, this is the most desired visa by every person who wants to migrate to Australia. To get a skilled visa in Australia, your skill needs to be assessed by the relevant authority. You can also get a company to sponsor you and apply for a working visa under company sponsorship in Australia. Next, temporary graduate visa, subclass 485, graduate work stream. This visa is suitable for those who have just graduated from their study in Australia, especially from the trade course. With this visa, you will be able to work on a full-time basis and get working experience for a minimum 18 months in Australia. You can also get additional points for Australian permanent visa by joining the professional year program. First one, please bear in mind, you can apply for this visa within a limited time only. You will lose your chance to apply for this visa after 6 months, starting from the end of your study. Second one, make sure you have taken and hold a valid English test certificate in the last 3 years, as well as provide health insurance. And last but not least, you should apply for an Australian Federal Police check on time. Be sure that you will have enough time. A temporary graduate visa, subclass 485, would be beneficial if you would like to apply for Australian Permanent Residence, or PR. Follow this step by step and get things sorted out. First of all, you may want to seek professional advice and consult with a registered migration agent once you graduate from a Fed education to understand the available pathways for you and, of course, finding the most benefit out of your graduate visa. As long as you use your time on the graduate visa responsibly, you should be able to obtain enough relevant work experience to qualify for PR. Second, be updated. Immigration regulations change from time to time. Make sure you are on the right track and do not miss any updates on visa regulations and requirements. Third, consider your options. You may be able to find a company that wants to sponsor your next visa, or to apply for a skilled visa if you are graduating from a trade course. Oops, the next 1 million question will be, what if you don't meet the requirements for both of the visas? Wave the white flag, throw in the towel, surrender? Hell no. You can still find a suitable degree with your career path and apply for another student visa extension in Australia. And for you, the non-trade qualification in Australia such as business and finance, education and community services, events, tourism and media, information technology, retail services, fashion design and merchandising, don't worry, you still have opportunities. You can first apply for a student visa extension, gain higher qualification and continue your study in Australia by taking a bachelor's degree in the same field or any other field that matches your passion and chosen career path. And the second one, you can continue your study in Australia by taking other vocational courses in Australia to aid your current skills, or you can get a company to sponsor you and apply for working visa under sponsorship in Australia. Final tips. No matter what your circumstances are, you can discuss any queries that popped up in your mind about your plans after finishing your study in Australia and get a free phone or WhatsApp consultation with our professional agent in Education One. Free consultation? Sounds legit, right? Keep in touch with us through email, WhatsApp, or via phone. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you find it informative. I'm Savitri signing out and hope to see you back real soon on Education One YouTube channel. Bye bye!